The Philippines Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. says that the government may receive up to 30 million COVID-19 vaccines over the next 2 months. Galvez says that the country will receive 16 million doses this July. 3 million of those are from Johnson & Johnson's single-dose COVID-19 vaccine. More than 14 million other doses are then to be expected to arrive by August, half of which will be from Sinovac. Galvez also apologized for the delays in the vaccine deliveries, which caused several local governments to suspend or to limit their own vaccination drives.
May mga tinatawag po tayo na mga lean weeks, o yung tinatawag na medyong tagtuyot na ano po, na tinatawag natin na mga araw na napakahirap po ng supply during the first week and last week of the month. During the first day of the day of the month, nagkakaroon po sila ng tinatawag na preparation for deployment. So nagde-deploy po sila sa mga second week pa po. And then yung last week, nangyayari, nagkakaroon po sila ng inventory at nagkakaroon ng redeployment yung mga manufacturer. So ang nangyayari, ang ating mga vaccine dumadating po during the second week, third week or fourth week ng nambuan.
Sinovac applies for an amendment in its emergency use authorization here in the Philippines so that its COVID-19 vaccine can be used on children 3 years old and above. That's according to the Director General of the Food and Drug Administration, Eric Domingo. At present, only Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine has been allowed by the FDA to be used on minors from ages 12 to 17 years old. Children are, however, still not included in the Philippine government's vaccine priority list.
Yun pong sa gitna, yun pong Sinovac, Mr. President, today, just this afternoon, they already applied for an amendment of their EUA to include children. And in this case, children from 3 to 17 years old. So this is another potential vaccine that can be used for the pediatric age group. Our vaccine experts are now taking a look at the data and of course asking questions sa proponents and getting more information.
So far, only 2.8 million adult Filipinos have been fully vaccinated against COVID-19, far from the government's target to vaccinate 58 million adults by the end of this year. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte issues a stern warning to all of those selling COVID-19 vaccine slots. This comes amid reports of individuals involved in the practice, including one healthcare worker who was arrested in Mandaluyong City. President Duterte has ordered authorities to investigate the matter and to press charges accordingly.
The COVID-19 vaccines given by the government are not for sale. You're not allowed to buy. The government will take care of that. Do not press your luck too far. You might regret it. Bilihin ninyo. Ang walang pera, yung mahirap ang maalisan ng whatever the opportunity or for the slots taken away. Huwag ninyong gawin yan kasi nag-warning lang ako. Huwag ninyong gawin. Ganyan ang droga. Huminto kayo. Sinabi.
Now, as the country awaits more vaccine doses to be delivered, the national government directs local government units to prioritize second dose vaccinations for their remaining Sinovac supplies. That's as the government expects the next shipment from the Chinese manufacturer to be delayed to July 18th. Sinovac was initially expected to deliver a fresh batch of vaccines to the Philippines weekly beginning last month.
Meron tayong delay sa shipment natin ng Sinovac, although ginagawa ng paraan ni Secretary Galvez na mapaaga ito next week. Pero dahil nga sa delay ng pagdating ng shipment ng Sinovac, pinaprioritize natin sa ating mga LGUs, lalo na sa NCR, ang pag-administer ng second doses.
The new protocol goes against a previous announcement by the National COVID-19 Task Force authorizing LGUs to use their existing Sinovac supplies for first dose vaccinees. Meanwhile, the health department assures the public that second doses can be administered with a slight delay. But some local government officials can't help but be concerned.
we tell people na siguraduhin na yung second dose is kailangan nilang kunin, di ba? Pag na-delay yan, magkakaroon sila ng pag-iisip na pwede palang ma-delay. Hanggang yung delay na yan, makakalimutan na yan o makatamaran na yan ng tao puntahan.
Philippine Health Secretary Francisco Duque III is asking the United Nations and the World Health Organization to help poor countries secure more COVID-19 vaccine doses. Duque notes that many low-income countries have yet to secure a stable supply of vaccines. The appeal comes as wealthier nations are looking to secure booster shots for their own citizens. Duque says that he will write a formal appeal to the UN and to the World Health Organization. Health Secretary Duque is also calling for stricter border controls to help the country fend off the new Lambda COVID-19 variant. The World Health Organization classifies the Lambda variant as a strain of interest because experts warn that it may even be more dangerous than the Delta variant. This strain has been detected so far in Peru and in 35 other Latin American nations. Duque's statement also comes after the Philippines detected two more cases of the Delta COVID-19 variant, raising the total for confirmed Delta cases here to 19.
Kailangan talaga bantayan po natin dahil baka biglang maging variant of concern. So ano gagawin natin? Patuloy na paigtingin ang ating border control, okay? Para makasiguro hindi ito makalusot mula po sa ating mga ROFs or OFWs.
Several experts are also urging the government to improve and to develop the Philippines' own genomic surveillance capacity to better monitor the presence of the different COVID-19 variants in the country. A doctor from the Okta Research Group says that the National Capital Region may become resilient to the Delta variant in just a few months. That same doctor, Nicanor Austriaco, also says that this will depend on whether or not vaccinees get their second doses on time.
As of yesterday, the NCR has received 29% of single doses, and each LGU has vaccinated between 20% to 70% of their population one dose, which suggests that a month from now, or a month and a half from now, that will be fully vaccinated people.
Austriaco also warns against easing the restrictions for fully vaccinated individuals too soon.
One of the things we have to distinguish here is between what is called effective immunity, where I do not get sick, okay, versus sterilizing immunity, which means I don't get sick and I cannot give it to you. That's what we're waiting for Sinovac and some of the other vaccines. We have that data now for Pfizer and Moderna, especially from the Israeli experience. And the UK experience with AstraZeneca. Those countries suggest that those vaccines prevent transmission as well, which is why they're able to remove masks.